Schwiegertochter wird das mit. Who's going to do the member statement?
No problem. During his State of the Province address, Gauteng Premier, like many other premiers that came before him, made a lot of promises and outlined unrealistic plans. The Premier made a lot of reference on a program that he and his government termed a program of radical transformation, modernization, and reindustrialization of Gauteng. This plan sounds like a solution to many problems our people in this province are faced with. But that's if you don't know your story. If you care to listen, you'll be convinced that Gauteng will no longer have informal settlement. You will indeed believe that poverty and hunger will be a thing of the past in this province, and that the poor and the unemployed youth of this province will no longer have to drink their pain and sorrow away, because indeed, tomorrow will be better than today, and that indeed they will find jobs. But the sad reality is that all of his plans are based on a failing program that is called the National Development Plan. This plan leaves intact the modern colonization, which is the domination of black people in general, Africans in particular, by a class of white South African monopoly capitalists and their foreign allies. The fact is that NDP will never advance the interest of the Freedom Charter and fails to understand the working class perspective on the control of South Africa's economy. Now, Speaker, I therefore wish to take this opportunity to remind the Gauteng people that the struggle continues, because political freedom without economic freedom is meaningless. That is why it is important to strengthen our land occupation program. It is important to bypass all prepaid water meters in Soweto and other places and ensure that access to water becomes a human right. We need to continue winning SRC elections in all institutions of higher learning and ensure that free and quality education becomes a reality. It is only the AFF that understands that our people need real change and cannot eat ideas. 21 years is more than enough, and our people want change now. I thank you.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I just want to announce and make a statement to the project of Zone 20, okay, of waterworks.
Sorry, Madam Speaker. Rising on Rule 80.5. I'm trying to check whether it's parliamentary for someone to speak that they will bypass water meters in this house. They will illegally bypass water meters. I'm trying to check.
Okay. Can I allow
Honorable
Kayana to read the other statement? This one will be responded to by members of the executive utilities.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker, and Honorable MEC, that this will be. All right, now mine is very, it's the issue of Sebokeng Waterworks. The one that the MEC spoke about, that it was resolved. He had a meeting with members of community. Today, as we speak, people were shot there, the road was closed, and the MEC reported that the project would be resolved, the issue of the project. But this morning, as we speak, very same project of waterworks in Sebokeng, it has caused another situation where people were shot, they were closing the road, demanding that the contract must come back. So can I ask the MEC to continue to intervene on the issue, because the situation is getting worse. Thank you very much.
Thank you. The first item on the agenda, members, I did not